Hi, today is December 26, 2013. Hopefully everybody had a nice holiday, nice Christmas holiday. I just want to do a brief video on a couple of the Dow stock. And right now the Dow and the market is continuing to hit all-time high. And there are some lagger in the under the Dow 30. And if these lagger start perking up, you could see that the Dow is just going to continue to move to a higher level. And it's also could bring up a sort of warning sign as well. So as the wind shift, we have to be alert and shift with the wind. So basically sway with the wind here. And the first one that I want to look at is essentially IBM. And I posted the IBM chart earlier and talked about the possible intermediate double bottom here. And it's trying to break out of this pivot of this 1825. You can see that while the Dow is hitting all-time high in the last few months, or in the, even during the last few session there, the IBM is still way beneath the peak up here back in early 2013, earlier this year, up at the essentially somewhere around the 216 area, up here. So if this guy start moving up and stop breaking out of this pivot, certainly with IBM being the second heaviest weight in the Dow 30, that could put a lot of leverage on moving this Dow up, and just by moving a couple point. And then the other guy that I want to take a look at is also McDonald. You can see McDonald is also kind of pretty, way underneath this peak back in April of this year, and right now it also seems to be rising above to this rise, this little channel, this consolidated declining channel. And if you look at the weekly or the monthly, you could basically see this as a little consolidation pullback. And some people call this a complex pullback, a complex consolidation. But in regardless, if we see this thing breaking out of here up at this level, the peak is somewhere around 98.70. So if we go above that 99 area, this stock could try to make a run up back up to this peak here, or somewhere around 103, 104. Now, previously, I did put out a little bit watch on the about breaking out of this trend line here, and you can see that after that day that I put it out, it actually gapped up. And depending on what your trading plan, if you did get caught on this gap and you chase it, then you should have stopped out at maybe a minimal loss or on a break even. And if your trading plan doesn't allow you to go and chase the gap open, then you are pretty much safe. But right now it came back down. It seems like you found a little bit of a support down here near this 95, I mean 94 area, and it seems to be coming back up. So we basically want to see, can it break above this trend line, which is near the 200-day moving average here, this red line here, somewhere around 98. So again, this is another guy that could perk up and help push the Dow, continue to push the Dow higher. And then if you believe this catalyst about the improving economy, and you can see that caterpillar here, you can see I put out an arrow here. You can see that all these support level, and you see these essentially a higher low that it continues to make every time it come down and touches this. It's pretty much the same level, and it came back up here on this resistance here somewhere around the 89 area. And it's been touching, for quite a few time, and it finally broke through last week, prior to, well, maybe it's just, last Friday, I believe. Today's Thursday, so it's basically it's this week here, Monday, probably. Anyway, it's on the 19th. So right now, it seems to be, trying to, hold above this area here. It finally broke this peak here, this pivot of 89.79. So if this, too, is also going to run, and it's come back up to this area somewhere around this, $99.70, the intraday high here. And again, these believe caterpillars have a weighting factor of or number 12 in the Dow on the weighting factor. So again, when caterpillar move, that's also could put some some leverage of moving the Dow up or down. So those are the three Dow stock that seems to be a little bit lagging, while the Dow Industrial have been hitting all-time high. So when these guys finally start perk up, look for the Dow to continue to push to a higher ground. And that's why I'm keeping an eye on the Diamond, the DIA, on the ETF for the Dow 30. So hopefully, you have been I have a very prosperous 2013 trading year, and if it's not, then certainly maybe it's a good time to go back and reassess to see what you have done right and what you have done wrong, and get ready for a more prosperous 2014. So I don't talk to you folks before the new year arrive. Happy New Year.